PinchyPenny.com. My guest today, my fabulous guest today, is Lisa of the Domestic Life Stylist. Hello, Lisa. Thank you for being here.
Hi, Sarah. Pleasure to be here. Thank you so much for having me.
You are welcome. Now, Lisa and I met about a year ago at Disney Social Media Moms on the Road in DC, and I saw her and I thought, oh my gosh, she is wearing a hat. For those of you who do not know, I want to be a hat person. I have the world's like largest melon, and it's not happening.
So my gosh. No, you don't.
I'll have to show you sometime. And then my hair gets out of control, but you were wearing the cutest red beret. You were working it. You were styling it. And I loved it. So we bonded over our love for Disney.
Yeah. And I had a bun in the oven.
She did.
Too. Who's now 11 months.
Oh my gosh. Yeah. And that was the other thing. She's one of those people you turn around, you're like, oh my gosh, she's pregnant. It looked like she swallowed a cantaloupe. It was just like, boop. So, but yeah, it's almost 11 months. Wow. I guess that's what happens.
Yeah.
So Lisa is one of my blogging friends. She is a fabulous travel, lifestyle, domestic goddess blogger. And I'm slightly jealous, I will admit it, of her travels and all the places you've been. Tell us about some of the places that you have traveled in your lifetime. Just a couple of them.
There's
a
lot. Okay, well, Bali, Indonesia, London.
I say London, I remember.
Caribbean, all over. You know, Dominica, Dominican Republic, St. Thomas, Virgin Islands is where I grew up. So, you know, California, Tennessee, Paris, Belgium. I've been to South Africa. Yeah, so I would say that's a good chunk.
That's putting your passport.
And I'm about to go to Bahamas this weekend, so I'll put that there too.
Awesome! Oh my goodness! Yay! So yeah, she is definitely a travel blogger. She is also a domestic blogger. You should check her out, domesticlifestylist.com. Beautiful photographs and recipes and hosting parties, and it's just. She's everything. She is domestic.
Thank you.
You are welcome. So through all of your travels, you've seen different cultures, whether it's food or interaction or cultural tendencies. What is something you do in your home that I may not do in my home because I haven't been to some of these fabulous places that you've visited? Maybe you take off your shoes when you come to a room, you serve tea at tea time. Mm-hmm. Is there something that you do that I wouldn't necessarily do?
Well, we have tea in our home. It's not at a specific time. I've been to London a few times, but specifically, I've been to the Ritz London. And they have a afternoon tea a couple times a day. It takes 6 months ahead of time. You need to make reservations for you to get in to this afternoon tea. So it's actually listed as one of the top things to do before you die in one of these books a couple years back. So I've been there, so I do know what proper afternoon tea looks like and etiquette and so forth. But we don't get that formal here, but we do have tea 3 times a day. And I may just take my tea while I'm walking around, but I try to at least slow down just a little while I'm having the tea. Whether it be 5 minutes. So I have tea 3 times a day. Our daughter is 4 years old, and she has started to ask for tea.
Nice. Monkey see, monkey do.
Yes, I know. I did go to this Tivana. I'm not sure if you have a Tivana where you live, but I did go to Tivana a few weeks ago, and I got a proper, like a tea kettle with a tea press, so it's see-through and transparent, and I can see the tea as it's steeping and so forth. And I was having a cup, and I had... Yeah, and one of the things I do also, sometimes I just stream, like, you know, classical music and so forth. So I'm having a cup because I'm trying to slow down, right? So I'm having a cup, and my daughter asks for, you know, can she have some tea? No, she said, what kind of tea is that? So I was just like, mine, she's four, okay?
Yeah.
Like literally not even four and a half yet. So I said, it's a Caribbean mate with a something mix because the person had custom blended something for me.
Nice.
She said, I said, would you like some? She said, no, thanks. I'll just, I want green tea.
This four-year-old was not liking the custom blend that mom had.
And
she'll just have the green tea. Thank you.
No, she doesn't want the custom blend. No, she wants she wants a cup of green tea. I'm looking like, really? But another thing that we do in our home is, you know, throughout the travels, I know people like to buy t-shirts sometimes, key rings. I used to buy mugs initially because we drink so much tea, but it started to get cluttered. So what I prefer to do now is get like a local spice or something from the area, and I use it in my cooking. Oh. So my last trip, well, the trip before the last was to Mexico. So it was, I guess I didn't mention that when I was talking about places, but it was my first trip to Mexico. So I got Mexican vanilla.
Ooh, nice.
When I went to Spain, I got Spanish paprika. You know,
great,
like the Spanish paprika.
Excellent.
When I went to Jamaica, I got the Jamaican curry.
Excellent.
So that's just one of the things that I do in my home, because I do most of the cooking because I love to cook. So I like to use native spices or blends from the area and do that. Because, listen, I don't use keychains, and it's just too much. You know, it's much more exciting. I like to experience a place through cuisine. And another nifty thing that I do here, or we do at home, is we have a cool map. It's actually more interactive. We have a Caribbean and global map, and we have a U.S. map. And there's little pins that you can put into the destinations. So we have a different color pin for places we've gone. We have a different color pin for places we're going. And we have a different color pin for favorite places that we visited. So right now, there's a pin in Bahamas and favorite places. We have a pin in Bali, and we have a pin in the Virgin Islands. So, you know, so my daughter can put the pin in, and she can kind of learn geography as we grow, you know, go on and so forth. So there's just a few things that we do.
That is, those are all great. I agree. You really need to experience the full culture, not just the touristy things when you go internationally. Well, local as well,
right?
But really bringing back those spices and those teas, that is a great tip, and you can truly relive a piece of your experience at home.
Right, and you're right. It doesn't have to be international, because I haven't been to Washington State, but if I did go, I would be looking for. I would want to have an apple.
Yeah,
I would want to have. You know, if I go to South Carolina or something, I want to take some Southern barbecue. That's mm-hmm. just, you know, I experience the place through its cuisine mm-hmm. and the people, of course.
Of course, yeah. Well, another thing, my husband and I went out to dinner last night, and we took with us a bottle of wine that came from Washington State. So you might want to check out wineries in Washington State if you ever make it out there. Not just apples. I think they're a little more than apples out there.
Oh yeah. Oh, that sounds like fun.
Yeah.
Although I smell alcohol and I get. But but I'm the one of those people. No, I would still go just to say I've been to the winery.
You've been to, yeah.
So did you have any wine? No, I didn't have any wine. But yeah. I heard it's one of the top wineries, so I went.
It is, yeah. And I'm fascinated by the process of how long the grapes have been there, and what the vineyard how it operates, and mm-hmm. the blending, and it's just, I love a good story. I love a good backstory. So you have two little ones that you travel with. Some of us have one, some of us have three or four, but you do travel internationally with both of them?
Yes. My son, who I said is 11 months, he's been on, he went to Mexico with me, but we went to Mexico together. So it was just him. So I didn't have two to handle, but he's going to the Bahamas with us. So that will be his second stamp on his passport. And listen, the crazy thing is, people are like, oh, wow, your son has already been to two international places. Our daughter, when she was 6 months, she already probably had three or four stamps. So
he's
a little behind.
I say he's slacking. He's got to step
it
up a little bit.
He's slacking.
So how do you handle them traveling internationally with their eating? I know some of my kids can be very picky at certain times in their lives. How do you handle that?
Well, this is the thing. I don't really pack too much food.
Okay.
I actually prefer to experience the place via the cuisine. And even if it's a baby, like when we went to Milan with our daughter, I think she had just started solids. So maybe she was 10 months, a year or something like that. But we would go to the restaurants, and I would just ask them for, you know, whatever the vegetable was, or if it was a native vegetable, I would just ask the chef to puree it for me.
Oh, nice.
So yeah, I try to mostly just eat off the menu. But you know, based on what they have in the kitchen.
Sure.
You know, I just consult with the chef or whoever's back there, and I typically ask them to steam it. For my daughter, she actually is a pretty good eater, so I have a bias for children's menus. I really do. But if people's kids are not acclimated to these flavors and so forth, most places that you go, if it's an American friendly hotel, you can go to the children's menu and there are things that your kids would be familiar with. Okay. For our kids or my 4-year-old, I tend to just order off the regular menu because I feel like she gets more of the culture that way.
I agree.
And I think that the kids' menus tends to be a safety net. So that's what I tend to do. But I have to say though, when my son and I, we went to Mexico, I did pack a couple of those food in the pouch, organic food, like things.
The squeezy pouches?
Yes, yes. Yeah. I did just in case, since I wasn't familiar with the hotel or their brand, or, you know, I just wanted to make sure that he was going to be as comfortable as possible. So in that case, I did. But I like to change it up a bit. And so, you know, like when we go to the Bahamas and so forth, if there's a local fruit or something, you know, I'll probably just puree it up, you know, have him have some of it.
That's great. I would like to think that my kids would take to different cuisines. They would probably take it to it for a little bit, but if we were there for like a week, by day 4 or 5, they're going to be like, I need my chicken nuggets. I need my quesadilla. You know,
the thing about it is, like, especially McDonald's, for example.
Okay.
They are all over the place.
That's
like,
true.
Like, I've been to, I was in Milan.
Okay.
I saw a McDonald's in Bali, Indonesia.
Wow.
Yeah. Dominica West Indies has a KFC, and I'm not sure if they have a McDonald's yet, but you'd be surprised.
What you can find.
Yeah, what you can find.
Keep your eyes open.
You know what they tend to do at the Golden Arches in these other countries? They tend to put a few native things in there, like a few native spins.
Yeah.
But then you can still find some of your familiar favorites. So it's actually fun going to, because sometimes I go to the Golden Arches and say, man, ours doesn't look like this.
No, why don't we have this for a couple weeks where we are?
Yes.
Things like that. So neat. That is fun. So you are so much more than a travel blogger. Tell me a little bit more about the pieces and parts of Domestic Life Stylist.
Okay, so there's a heavy travel component, but it's a hefty food component as well, because I love to cook and I love to eat.
Yes.
And so because of that, you can find some of, well, my original recipes. What I put on the side are typically original recipes, foods I would prepare in my home. So I call that food style. I also have topics that moms will find interesting, such as health, well-being, you know, just raising your kids. So I have mom style.
Okay.
I have topics that involve going out to your family, spring activities, summer activities. So that's family style. So anything having to do with your family. I recently implemented, I have a travel style, obviously, because there's a lot of travel.
Yes.
And I have topics dealing with island culture. I just started it.
Okay.
So it needs a little bit more information, but I have an island style section.
Okay.
So in the island style section, you can find out about island fruits, island culture. If I go to an island, I'll talk about island topics there. So basically, you're talking about lifestyle, travel, food, I mean, well-being. I call it mommyscaping. Like, I'm going to start incorporating more fashion, mommyscaping, health. It pretty much runs the gamut, but more so heavily on the side of food and travel. But there's definitely something for everyone. Oh, and how could I forget? I love to shop at a grocery store. Like, I'm one of these crazy people. Like, I love a grocery store. Like, get excited. Oh, like, oh my gosh, we're going to the grocery store. So I have a grocery style section. And there you can find tips on shopping at a grocery store, shopping with your kids. I also have a monthly calendar, what you can look forward to saving on each month. So we have, you know, June savings, May savings, and you can go back until January. I recently started that. So, yeah. That's some of the topics that you can find under Domestic Life Stylist.
I check those, what to save in the month of, all the time. You have some great lists. Those are wonderful.
Oh, thank you.
You're welcome. So tell me about, you have a couple other projects you are involved in, one with 5 Minutes for Mom.
Yes, I am actually the fine living / travel expert, if you will, at 5 Minutes for Mom. So I have a column that goes live every Thursday. It's called Ask the Domestic Life Stylist. And what readers do, they send their questions to askthedomesticlifestylist.com. And I basically answer their questions, and their questions can have anything to do. It can be any topic from travel or, you know, food topics or lifestyle, raising young kids. And I pick a question every week. So every week, you know, readers can go to 5minutesformom.com. And they'll see my column there where I answer different reader question every week. So it's kind of fun, and people like to, you know, send in their questions and come back and see what my take is on, you know, certain topics. So it's a lot of fun. I've been doing that with them since February of this year.
Excellent. Congratulations. It sounds like a great fit.
Thank you so much. Thank you. And as their travel lifestyle person as well, in that capacity, I'll probably get to go on a few trips and so forth. So the trip I went to Mexico with my son, that was through 5 Minutes for Mom.
Excellent. So you probably share those trips through social media. So what are
Yes, I do.
What are your social media handles?
Well, on Twitter, it's D Life Stylist, D as in dog, Life Stylist. On Pinterest is also D Life Stylist. And you can find me on Facebook and Google Plus at The Domestic Life Stylist.
Excellent. Thank you. And Instagram too, correct?
Actually, I'm not on Instagram yet.
We got to change that. We got to get you on that Instagram.
I will be soon.
I'm going to push you into that one.
You know what, Sarah? Let me tell you. Listen, if I wasn't a blogger, I would be such the, like, not tech savvy person. So sometimes I get overwhelmed.
It is a lot.
It's
finding a balance.
So I just signed to Google Plus. You know when I signed on to Google Plus, because I told you. Remember when we had little thing.
Yeah.
So I signed up to Google Plus last year, and I told myself, it's really like these stupid rules I make up. I told myself, okay, well, that was the one social media for this year. So there's no more for this year.
Cut it off.
I'm like, it's going to be one a year. It's going to be one a year. So I haven't signed up for anything in 2014. So maybe it'll be Instagram.
It should be Instagram, because you have beautiful photos, and I want to see where you're going in the palm of my hand. So,
oh my God.
Do it for me, please. All right, Lisa, thank you so much for taking time out of your day to be on Our Two Cents. I thank you 1,000 times, and I will have all those links in the information below, and you can follow Lisa at The Domestic Life Stylist.
My pleasure indeed. I want readers, everyone, to live life at home with finesse and style.